If I'm on nuke, I'm in tears the moment I realise that I'm starting T. I'm already in tears, James.
Yeah, I mean the way this has become an odd map where. Oh, by the way, actually, before we just go into that, Steam Valve just recently updated this map, and now, ladies and gentlemen, now there is a boiler in boiler.
There it is.
There it is. That is the boiler itself. Hopefully it doesn't make any weird noises.
How is this new? Look at it. It's rust all over it.
It looks like it needs repair.
Jeez, Valve, come on.
They've also fixed some kind of...
like a third-hand boiler, just like ripped out of like a derelict building.
I know. The water-worn boiler.
But to get into the game here, full of piss around between Denial and Savage on Inferno, we do have ourselves a passive opening from both teams. Denial just, you know, leaving themselves open to some just strong positions. Hit maybe Fugly in with a peek to see if there is any kind of apartments take here for Savage. But we can see that they are slowly working their way towards A. It looks like an A posture. There is that potential for that B double back, but they've not left anyone there. So it would be quite risky. And the smoke off too long here. Now, does this mean they're going to go for the quad push? It does look like they are putting a lot of pressure on quad right now. Fugly with a good quick defense right there in the apps. Oh, and holding this position so well. And now as Glorian's left alone, he's going to be looking for that bomb dropped on the site, but there's players all over. And Savage are going to go down on the first round there. Denial up one. And Savage on the eco without a bomb plant.
Fugly putting in work there for his team. Got 4 out of 5 frags, 80% of the frags there. Gets a quick pick on the person in apps. Sees there's no one behind him. Manages to peek, use the wall to his advantage. Take out one player, go back, come out again. You know, giving the T's 2 places to look at because they had a guy on the site and they have him popping in and out of apps like a jack-in-the-box as well. So very difficult situation for Savage there. Unable to take down Fugly, who does get the 4 of those 5 frags. And it will be 1-0 to Denial here. And we will see a P90 from that.
This is a really nice push here. Just the flash up. This is really popular on the top level as well. And they're just going to go for those quick picks. Maybe get a really fast bomb plant. Oh, and they're not actually able to get more than 1 frag just yet. Hades does pick himself up a Famous though. So let's see if he's able to actually get much more of this. Another frag or two to put that economic pressure on Denial would be fantastic. Ideal. Can he get it? Hades drops. Nah. But it will be Daps to take him out swiftly afterwards. But that is the base amount of economic damage that they were going for. And we can see that because they didn't buy up any armor, they can just get the PD50s this round and then can do it all over again. Keep that economic pressure on Denial. And I think they're happy with that.
Seeing a Deagle here from Dumour, CZ from Glorin's, and otherwise we are going to have 2 P250s and 1-man Glock train for Hades here as they once again approach the A bomb site. No plant yet for Savage here, so it will be 3 ecos rather than 2. And we'll see if they can be more successful on this occasion. That nade will put Hades down to 91, so not doing a terrible amount of damage, but one step to the right, and he may have been on 60 to 40 HP here. We can see the CTs slowly edging down Banana. We've got Daps just making his way down as Nafly rotates towards the A bomb site. So some vital information here from the CTs. If you get an extra man over there.
And look at this, they have them absolutely sandwiched in here. Oh, Daps actually going down from behind. But we do have the push coming in from CT Arch here, and it's looking pretty good. We do have a 1-on-3 situation on our hands, though. Glorian's with that P90, and oh, so colorful it is. But I wonder if he's going to be able to find any kills here. Looks like they aren't interested at all in hunting him down, and I don't blame them at this point in time. And
so it looks like Glorian's just taking a second there to kind of... The longer he hides, the more the CTs have to spread out and cover both bomb sites again, since they don't know where he is. There are 20 seconds left, though, so I am wondering if he is going to try and save this P90, although they're on a full buy next round, so it wouldn't make any sense. But is he going to give himself enough time to get this kill and get the bomb down? I mean, I don't think he's going to have enough time here.
This would be glorious if he's able to do it. All going to go for the quick plant, not checking the back of the site. No time, just has to go for it. And they do have a guy there ready to deal with that. And definitely, as you said, no point trying to save that.
Glorious Glorians.
And we do have Savage Hades going for this AWP. When Devil was here, we talked about AWPing on the T side a lot. And if if they have a read on denial that they love to go for the aggressive warping on CT, this is really, really good, actually, if he's able to execute. And looks like, in fact, we do have the AWP on Shazam. We've seen some great AWPing from him in the past. And looks like the smokes will deny any AWPing, actually, here for Shazam down mid. So largely going to be uncontested on that range. But perhaps Hades can find something towards Banana as the push is there. But they are backing away slowly.
So one of the Savage players did get picked on Banana. So they will be at a one-man disadvantage here. The bomb is in very early part of the map, so it's going to be picked up now, and we'll see where they go with it. I mean, they kind of have no choice but to push A, considering the CT positions here on Banana. They are going to go back slightly towards the bomb site as this push does come in on the A bomb site. Going to leave one guy on B, and potentially have another rotation and put four men on the A bomb site here. Got two people in pit here for denial, which is going to be a strong defensive position, especially if they can get a crossfire with somebody in site or graveyard. I think they've got Shazam in library here with the AWP. He's going to push towards site. And the defrags are coming in for Savage. They're going to get the plant on quad.
And Bugly coming up. Oh, he gets a double there. Oh, that's really nice there, just staying in that position. That's pretty well handled by denial there. They're very, very, very confident there, sitting on the site in their positions. And they delayed Savage a lot, and not able to get that site clear for the plant. So very awkward situation there for Savage.
One update I'm really happy about that Steam just released is now we can see all the grenades once again. In the last few days since the previous Steam update, it's only shown one grenade for each player. And oh, the one dig is real. And that is a massive pick for Savage on this eco here up mid.
And look at this, they are going to go in here pretty fast and heavy with those pistols, but Juvenile ready to deal with that. Oh, I love that pop flash. It's pretty sexy stuff there from Juvenile. And he does have a mate here in pit, Fugly. He's been locking this area down pretty well right now, but he's got to worry about apartments. He's there. Oh, he's ready for this angle. He's so ready for it. Oh, what a lovely little jump there. Gets the shot onto Hades. And it looks like that little pick attempt there from Savage is going to go awry. And this is going to make them feel a bit harder pressed to try to get an opening into this site. You have this AWP here on Glorians, though, so he could be the one to create something here.
Now, the CTs have only just seen the bomb there on quad, so we will see the rotate of the extra man here. So it's going to be a 3-versus-1 situation on this A bomb site, and I don't think the bomb's going to go down this time, but...
Oh my god.
The second dig comes out, and that third dig would have changed everything.
That would have been like movie material right there. That 180, that if he had made that, I would have sent him an email saying thank you for making my life better.
180 Juan dig.
But but unfortunately, he wasn't able to get it. But it's going to be 5-0, and Savage going to be on another buy.
And so no AK this time for Team Savage. And Shazam with his Dragon Lord looking down mid. Won't find anyone to face him just yet. The flash combination comes out, but there's no pick there for Savage. And Shazam will play a little bit more passive. That is somewhat of an aggressive smoke there, which will allow him to stay close for the time being. Both teams just looking for a pick at the moment.
Yeah, just trying to make that banana control work for them. They haven't touched apartments, really, and this is something that Denial don't know about. They haven't really set foot in apartments just yet in this round. And of course, looks like we're going to see an execution coming in here for this bomb site. Should see the grenades very soon coming over the top for Savage as they do ready themselves to go in for this rush execution. You can just see that Denial very tentative right now. They have a player... over this Shazam actually rotating. They have caught on to this now. So it's going to be very hard for them to pull this off because it is expected. And in they go. Looks like Daps able to take down one. Shazam also chiming in. An amazing angle for all of them right now. And they cannot get past the choke point. All getting absolutely slaughtered there on the approach to the B bomb site. And Relics to go down at the end by the car as he tried to desperately make an escape. He's like, nope, I'm out. I'm out. But 6-0 is the score now.
That's a very good counter flash there that you saw from Shazam. He was on the CT side of opposite the B bomb site. As the push came in from the T's, he bounced the flash off the wall that went into the pool area just below barbecue. So all the T's running into the site through the smoke would have been flashed. He saw the bomb carry there, ended up on his own in no man's land, and got completely eliminated while he was blind by the CTs, which ruined the round there for Savage. And it is going to be 6-0 denial. Savage will be on a full buy here, but they've lost a man already, on both teams, in fact, which will make the CTs a little bit weaker. Currently, Arch is completely unprotected, but the Cs don't know that yet, and they are being flanked from Banana.
Dab's in a good position to deal with this, actually tossing a Molotov, giving his position away, but oh wow, didn't expect that to happen. Jumping straight through the fire, and it looks like now the bomb is well underway to Banana here, just getting through really fast. We do have Shazam ready though, he can make the difference for Denial. In goes the flash, has to reposition. Good smoke there from Savage as they make their way onto the bomb site. Shazam coming in from the back, oh barely not making the kill just there with that orb. There it is, takes down Hades, and it's just two players left here for the CT side as Glorians tries to clutch this down. Gets the one-on-one now. That bomb ticking away. Fugly makes his way in, but also making his way out just as quickly as he came. And we have a round for Savage. Wonderfully done.
8 rounds remain, so they can still completely get back into this. If they win one more round, then the CTs will be on kind of critical life support where they will need to win the following round. Otherwise, they'll be ending up in an eco. They still can afford to buy an AWP for the time being, so Shazam is going to be there with the AWP. And Hades is going to be there to match him and going to be faster on the trigger and give the Savage team a one-man advantage early on in this round.
Look at this, Juvenile. Close to enemy lines, they're going to get punished through the smoke by Relics, in fact. And we do have Fugly here, also very close to some of the T's here in apartments. They are actually slowly vacating the area to make their way towards Banana. You can see Daps looking for perhaps a pick here. He's going to go straight and slowly forwards, try to see what's up. He may have no idea that there's so many players there, and they are going to take the kill and go all the way through. Now we've got Naf on the rotation. Also, we have Fugly going through Banana, but Naf is going to make first contact through the smoke. Throws in some spray, but not connecting anything just yet.
I think we may see a save here from Denial. I mean, at the moment, they've got control of both exit points from the bomb site, so they may try and get a quick pick, but no, it looks like Fugly's in fact going to go in for it here. So, oh, he does get taken out now, and Fugly has a decision to make. He's going to exit, pick up an AK first. And he's out of there. So I thought the CT would try and maybe get an early pick there as the bomb is ticking. If they can't get it, then they may try and just keep the terrorists on the site for as much as possible while saving their lives. Fugly does find an AWP on Banana mid area, so he will save that, which will be very important for his team if they can get an early pick in the next round. However, looking at the money, it will be a mixed buy if they force it up here.
So, Savage making their way back into this now. It was looking a little bit grim. We're getting pretty high up on the scoreboard there without any response, but we are seeing it now. They're finding, you know, a lot of success on this B site, I think. And we'll have to see now how this round develops. They didn't set much of a presence in towards the apartments that heavily last round, and this tends to be something that perhaps Denial could be looking at and say, okay, why don't we get more presence in apartments? Maybe we'll get a quicker reaction when they go back for these B plays.
We've got new bugs. It's not showing us half of the primary weapons that they have now. So maybe that was because the scoreboard was
I fixed it, James.
CSGO.
I'm a hacksaw.
Damn.
I just pressed escape twice.
We're a very nice work there. Let's see where.
That's why I'm here. To press escape.
Good stuff. See if Relic's looking to find a connection with someone's head here. But he has found the position of one of the CTs and will try and connect with a head, but may not be for a while as he rotates around to ruin. So looks like the terrorists are just trying to get a pick to play on at the moment as the time does run down. Are going to fake towards the B bomb site where there are in fact 3 CTs. So eventually this push does need to come. We do have another CT. Oh, it's almost a full rotation, but they realize it could be a fake and they're going to stay on the A bomb site for now.
So they're really selling this right now. Dap's going to take a frag here, but meanwhile, the action going on where the real threat is, the bomb is on this site. And look at that, bomb in hand at a very inopportune moment. Fugly deep in the site, and he's going to be able to take out that bomber. And it looks like Juvenile also able to take down Glorians. So now you got Hades on 4 HP with the Dragon Lord orb on the run.
That was the beginning of a nice fake, but it was really poor execution on the A bomb site, has to be said. You know, the fakes, the two T's on Banana pushed the B bomb site But the T's on the A-bomb site were still just walking around. One of them ran onto the bomb site holding the bomb. There was no check of the bomb site to see if anybody was there. He got eliminated, the bomb was down, and then that was pretty much the end of the round for them. So it was looking good for Savage there, and they should have taken it with the numbers advantage they had, but just I think the execution on the A-bomb site was just too slow.
Yeah, certainly they just seem to not really get much out of that. And we do have the deep banana smoke. So at the moment, actually, we have a fast, or what looked like a pretty fast movement up mid, but they kind of tapered it off a little bit and they're holding their ground in apartments. We've got a man on boiler here for Dumour, that is Dumour, and definitely looking to try to make their way in right now. It seems as if we have a proper rotation back onto A now. So that first, you know, three-man push on banana was not correctly exploited by Savage as they waited for so long, not realizing. And now they're slowly executing into A. But we're having a float, the floater coming in from B. And so this is going to be very difficult for Savage to do unless they clear pit very, very quickly. And in fact, it's looking very troublesome in the fair to actually get that pit clear. It's still alive right now. We've got Shazam coming in from library side. Just a full rotation. They are stuck on the bomb site. This is really awkward here for Savage. Pushed to the limit, back against the wall. Can they execute? Frags coming in left, right, and center here for denial. It's just Relics left now with the Tech 9 of all weapons. And it's going to be the round there for denial. And it was a really good retake. I feel like if Savage had just gone like 10 seconds earlier, boom, easy round.
Yeah, the double. The second person in pit for the CT seems to be working well for them, and you can see they got the frags there. Worth noting that the Tech 9 was also buffed in the update of a few minutes ago, and you can see them discussing them, asking how is it. Looking at this Steam release notes, it just says improved accuracy and reduced recoil of the Tech 9, but hopefully they haven't broken it again as they did when they first buffed it.
They should have added on the notes, but still worse than, still worse than CZ. Or still worse than...
When they first buffed it, it was basically like a negative with no recoil. We have to tap out each bullet.
Yeah.
Like, because they just completely broke the stats there. But
here comes the execution into that B bomb site. And with those pistols, they might be able to do some damage. They get through the choke points, and they're actually on top of the site itself. Dap's able to spray him down, though. And it looks like they do not get anything out of that. Unfortunate. Good, they had a... It could have gone well there, though. I like the idea. They're fast into the bomb site. And... perhaps they may go for that later on. But we are getting quite deep into the first half now between these two teams, where we see 12 rounds already played and a 9-2 scoreline in favor of Denial.
So 5 AKs here for Team Savage. Can't quite afford the AWP. I think there was maybe some discussion of buying one naked there, as one player did have 48.50. But they did buy a late AK, and Hades has left the building for round 12. And there's going to be a T spotted through the smoke here, unbeknownst to him. Does go down, but Glorian does get a trade kill here.
And we have Juvenile just low man hit on the bomb side itself, looking to slow this push down. Oh, he's not able to do that. A quick frag, exactly what they needed, exactly what the doctor ordered, and they get the bomb down. They even are going to get some afterplant setups here. It's going to be a little tight. Oh, Shazam, sick shot there onto Valens, and now things get tricky here for Savage. Glorian's in the corner there, and Relic's coming from behind on the boiler. Gets the double, the spray down. What a sick round there from Savage. Great, great ending. And it looked, didn't look so good for them going into that, but what a flank.
We are going to see another full buy here from Denial. It's going to be 9-3. Savage making their way further up the scoreboard here. Getting back into this game with 3 rounds left. 13, 14, 15. So they could make it to 9-6 here. It's important that they do. They need to give themselves enough of a cushion to make a comeback here on the CT side. If they lose the pistol with only 3 rounds, then they will be in a lot of trouble.
We've got Relics going for banana control here for Savage. It looks like a very standard round so far. They are taking it very cautiously and passively. We can note how slowly they're going up second mid to really spam apartments and really get a very good idea of what's happening there. And so they should be moving in here to try to take over. And they won't find any resistance, really. There's no one really from Denial in apartments. They haven't put a lot of pressure on apartments generally so far.
So there were some smokes thrown to the corner on Arch, where CTs like to hide from time to time. But there is no push just yet from the Ts. They're slowly starting to emerge up top mid at the moment, but there's only one player on his own, so if he does go down, there will be no trade kill, but he does take down Shazam, and that's Hades with AWP, just going hell for leather at the moment. Can he get the pick on site though? No, he's going to go towards CT and get a second pick there, and his team need to really force the issue here now.
Oh yeah, it's looking very, very tight here now for Denial. All of them like having a lot of trouble staying alive in their positions, and now Savage are just wrecking this bombsite defense. We've got Daps now, 1-on-3. Show us the goods, Daps, show us the goods. Or maybe not, maybe just save. Maybe just save, that's cool too. And this, we can check the money, and we can see that saving definitely is pretty good idea considering that they aren't going to be able to buy on the next rounds.
Yeah, he has a lot less than his teammates as well. If he if his money in the bank was on a similar level, then he could just go to do the economical damage because they will all aim to buy together anyway. But he has $50 in the bank with his teammates on 800 to 1250. So just better to save and stand by the fridge, kind of cool down for a moment before we go into round 14 here. Second match of the evening.
Definitely. So can just quickly also check out and see how people are doing as well. Pretty good game for Fugly actually on that that balcony defense, having a lot of frags. It's a position that we see, you know, when most teams play, that player often gets to do a lot of decision making and have a lot of opportunities to make a lot of frags. And we see, for example, NIP Forest plays that position, always gets a huge amount of frags when we see NIP playing. And right now, actually a bit of a push coming up.
Hades looking for the ultimate gap shot there. I don't think I've ever seen someone hold that angle and get the frag, so that would have been something to watch.
So Ray's going to just creep on in. There's a player behind the sandbags looking for the frag. Can he find it? Goes to the spray down, and the double peek coming in. Very well done there by Denial. They do lose a man, though. And we can see the reaction is for Shazam to rotate, and that's going to allow Savage to have an advantage whichever site that they pick. As long as the execution is far. Oh, nice jump over the smoke. And that's going to be it. I was just about, they took the words out of my mouth. They need to make it fast and they need to do it now. But actually, they have a lot of time left. So they're actually just going to kind of play it slow at the moment. But still, no matter which site they hit, if they go together, they've got a pretty good shot of taking it down. And they are going to go for this like sneaky play of having Hades alone with the AWP going towards A right now to try to keep the rotation really delayed onto B. Really good stuff here from Savage. And looks like they're falling for it. Look at this. We just have Daps now alone to defend against three players. And his teammates are so far away. He's going to try to wait for them though. Smart play coming in from Daps. But the bomb is going to go down. Here he is tested by Dumore. He will pass the first test. Here comes Juvenile through the smoke with the FAMAS. There's the double, and it's just one left at pool. It's going to be Valens. Takes down the next one. Fugly left with that bomb ticking away. Charging in from Banana. Player behind the fountain gets the spray, and that's going to be the round for Denial. What a tight round. Wonderfully played by both teams there. That was pretty intense. But Denial, by the skin of their teeth, pull it out.
Yeah, that was a critical two frags there during that early retake through the smoke from Denial, which allows him to get to 10-4, they stole that round back from Savage, a round they didn't deserve until the end, I suppose, with that play. It was an excellent play from them. The two Savage guys facing the site rather than kind of outwards where the CTs were mostly going to come from. So unfortunate timing for them. But 10-4, not the worst in the world. 10-5 will be, you know, still doable for them. So hopefully they can make this late stage comeback and get this last round. Valens only with a CZ, unable to afford a primary rifle here. So he may be holding corners or hanging in the background while his teammates try and get a frag so he can pick up a weapon.
Yeah, so far things are going slow. We do see a take of apartments, which isn't super standard here from Savage, which does, I would say, it's a bit of a tell almost from seeing their game so far. If Denial were able to pick up on it, that they are going to be making a play for A here. But they do have a man up Banana, so they're keeping that option open, and they're keeping the possibilities obscured for Denial. Here they are, they're actually making their way up for the A execute. Do have Fugly up in his position, up on balcony. In they go. Around both sides, Shazam on library. Not able to get much done. And they do manage to progress their way into the site. We do have now Fugly left alone. not able to even get one. Looking like a really good round here for Savage so far. We have the players rotating from B. Have to see if they're able to pull this one off as Daps makes his way through the lobby. Gets the first kill. Doesn't sustain all too much damage. Swapping out for the AK. We have two players here bleeding out for Savage right now. Hades and Valance very low, but they're both in the pit right now. Very, very safe positions as we do see Denial coming in slowly but surely. Naf going to get the frag. Now it's all on Daps, but he will get taken down by the Savage players over by pit. And they make it a 10-5 first half, so they do bring this back to what could be considered quite a respectable and achievable scoreline.
Yeah, this is a reasonable score, especially as they were 5-0 down at least.
No, oh yeah, I think even 6-0 actually.
Yeah, they lost a hell of a lot of rounds in a row. So reasonable comeback from Team Denial here, sorry, Team Savage. They will need to win this pistol, otherwise it is going to be a long and arid road to victory for the CT. So we'll see what happens on this pistol round.
And already Shazam's head getting popped. Definitely a good start for Savage.
Absolutely good start for Savage, definitely. They do really, really need this pistol.
Alright, so they're still waiting to react to Denial. It's Denial, they're in the driving seat right now. They get to decide where to go. And Savage have still to react. Oh, and look at that. Getting Glorians down straight away. They're going to just go off the back of this aggression and try to get their way into the bomb site. Oh, the flank down onto Relics. Not looking quite the right way at the right time. And the bomb is going to get planted as a result. Now we're in an even situation. We do have Hades coming up from the back, but look at Daps. Really good position here in Boiler. I don't think he's actually been detected just yet. So this could be very, very dangerous right now as we do have the other players moving into the, on top of the site. We've got Dumor in, trying to get the frags. Can he make it happen? One on two, the bomb ticking away. Doesn't even have a kit. And it's going to be a round for Denial. It started out so well for Savage.
Yeah, that's unfortunate. You could see the CT, they had a one-man advantage, but he was picking for information in apps and they got his head popped off, and that just opened up the round there for Denial, who managed to bring it back to 11-5. And now the Team Savage have decided to go for the eco rather than the force, which makes sense because Denial are 5 rounds away from winning for the time being. Although, if they do lose this round, it would be interesting to see what they choose to do in the following rounds. But Team Denial here with 3 Galils and 2 AKs. Actually, no, the Team Savage have forced it up here with, they've got armor helmets and 5.7s and a mixture of P250s as well. One kit on Valens, who's going to be, well, was previously playing Arch last round, but is currently on the B-bomb site, may rotate later on. So they're going to be going for those close quarters one-shot pops. Got Hades playing Arch now and slow rotation coming back, but that's from Relics rather than the kit holder Valens.
Yeah, it's very, very, very important to actually know that he is the only one with the kit as well. And right now we do get the pick onto Hades. So let's see now how far they can get here. We do have someone in balcony. I think it was Lawrence. There he does go down, does take the kill onto Naf there. But it looks like Valens and Dumor are left. So we have to see what they're able to accomplish. They're really far away, obviously, you know, being on the B side of the map. So very, very difficult time here for Savage. With these, this very scrap together by already in a position of looking at the round score. They don't have many rounds to play with, and they took an economic risk here with the pistol armor. And
yeah, they should be saving their armor here. It looks like Villains is going to be Dumor is going to be hanging around, just trying to get an exit frag, chance of picking up a weapon. So worth the risk there, but he's going to exit towards CT spawn, so they won't be able to pick up that weapon from the player they killed this round.
See, I think there are those that would have disagreed with that buy, considering how many rounds behind they are, and you know, because the risk of losing it is so huge in how it affects your future buys. And right now we can see Savage on the eco, and Denial winning this, that puts them obviously 13-5. Only 3 rounds away then from actually winning the match against Savage on Inferno here.
Dumor manages to get knifed by his teammates in CT spawn before even moving an inch, and he is going to leave CT spawn on 78 HP.
Wrong angle there.
They have stacked the A bomb site as well. So we're seeing some baiting here from Juvenile on Banana, but there's nobody home. And 2 fast frags here from Boiler, where there's now a Boiler. Comes the third one after the trade kill from Relics, and only Villains remains, and there goes their armor. and we'll see what the CTs choose to do next. No money for the AWP, so they are going to be four M4s, unless Dumour has the M4A4, in which case he'll be forced to buy the FAMAS.
And looks like we have the nades fixed, actually.
Yeah, now, we do,
is,
yeah.
Which is good. So thank you, Valve. That was didn't take them too long to fix that, which is nice. I think only two or three days.
Yeah, it was a difficult
fast.
Time, but, you know, we got through it.
We had our tricks to get through it, indeed. And right now we're seeing a bit of a stack here towards this B-bomb site, where, you know, things might get heated pretty fast here for Valens. Let's try that camera angle again. There we go. That's a bit better. We can see the players on that site, and they're likely to be tossing in the nades very soon, very shortly, and we're obviously going to need to see a lot of frags here from Valens in this close position, as it's so committed for this defense to actually go well. And here they go, make their way in. New denial. Players towards pool right now, and nothing found by Valens. Really, really big loss here. Complete cleanup of the site almost immediately here, as the bomb does go down. We see them spreading all the way out here, and they're actually going to go for the save of the M4s, which is really smart here from Savage. There's no point like risking losing three weapons in this situation, and that's going to be 14-5 after this round here.
Okay, so Savage between a rock and a hard place at the moment, possibly going for this dirty boost above the exit of T-spawn, but maybe not going for the crossfire set up behind the chicken coop instead, as we do have some T's fishing around looking for some CTs to terrorize. We'll see if they manage to connect with anyone. Juvenile not going to find him just yet. Pre-firing whatever that thing is. But there's nobody there. So, Savage in a very difficult situation here. Gonna have to force two rounds away from taking the L here. We've got one FAMAS and four M4s, so not doing terrible. No helmets for Relics or Hades, but against the AKs, it won't really matter. Shazam, however, does have a FAMAS, which will turn into an AK if he does meet with one of those two guys.
A slow start here for Denial, as they do take themselves some banana control. It's a little bit of a pop flash there for Fugly to just improve his position and his grasp of the general area, and make sure that there are no CTs there, flush them out, and we get the apartments take, the simultaneous apartments take. It's the standard, most standard thing that you'll ever see on Inferno, and it builds into so many potential round endings, where you're able to like finish with a rush on either site, or take even more map control towards A. There's lots of things that they can do. It's all about delaying these CTs from understanding what's happening. And we do get the smoke towards Quad right now, which is very scary for the CTs, not knowing what's actually going on Quad. And we do have a lot of pressure potentially for Hades, who's actually towards long side, and actually going to abandon the position immediately without actually even spotting. And Ingo Denial going to get a very clean push into the bomb site. Let's see what they can find now, as the players are just getting dropped left, right, and center. But it looks like Denial left with only daps at this point in time, moving from the truck. Can he find any frags? He's got three players to take down, and Savage are looking very glorious in this round so far. Dap's going to get one before he gets taken out, but we do get ourselves a round for Savage, as they are going to keep the hope alive, keep the flame kindled.
Denial are nowhere near an eco right now, so Savage are going to be up against it every single round for a while. Shazam with the AWP here, we'll see where he goes with this. And we do have two AKs on Savage, which will help them a little bit. They're going to peek mid, seeing the aggressive smoke down mid from the CTs. And a sneaky position here from Relics, but he's going to back off to the site. They may have heard some sound. They do have three people on the bomb site in case there's an early push here. They will be better equipped to mount a defense.
Yeah, this looks super good here for Savage, actually. Really strong read from them. And oh, there's the pick from Shazam, though. They're going to think this is a free affair, but look at that. Oh, no, Relics goes down straight away, gets nothing. And now, Savage, in a terrible position. Their rotation is quick, but it's such a clean take at the site. Denial with the bomb down there by the grill, and Naf going to find Dumour as well. And oh my goodness, Glorian's falling as well. The hope rests on Hades behind the smoke, but he doesn't even get a chance to fire a single shot before he does get taken out. So Denial now on match point, and things look great for them.
Ooh, Savage have next to no money, next to no chance of winning this round unless they get very, very lucky. That you saw the push come in from B, the smoke went down, but a flash would have been more useful. They may not have been aware of how many people were that close to them, but obviously, you know, denial of vision by a flashbang would have been more ideal in that situation, but then hindsight's 20/20. So we do go into potentially what's the last round of this. We've got Glorin's just rushing forward against an AK with a 5-7, which isn't going to pay off for him, unfortunately. No better guns available to him due to a lack of funds, and that's going to be a quick one-man advantage for Team Denial here.
Look at this, Hades behind the smoke, really close. He's going to pop flash himself in, actually. Ooh, he actually gets the flash. Oh, and finds the frag, finally. Barely gets it on the bomb carrier, and they're going to know now. So they're going to rotate the guys from B, but the problem is that because he died straight away, they can do anything with this, but they're just going to be like, all right, guys, it's two pistols. What are they going to do? Let's just hit the A side. Let's end this right now, right here. And there goes the bomb. So Dumore is going to have to show us the sickest Deagle action, but he won't. Only one kill. 16-6, and I think once again we had a result that I think mirrored general public opinion.